You know life bee swarm too much. No, I don't. Yes, you do. No, I don't. Yes, you do. No, I don't. Yes, you do. No, I do not. I don't know life bee swarm that much. Hey, this video is of me getting Tide Popper and Bee Swarm and the journey that I took to get there. This video took over a month to record, so please make sure to like and subscribe, and of course share this with your friends. But without further ado, the video. Alright, first day. Let's go check our quests. Two 28 quests? Alright, I think it's time for some grinding.
You were the shadow to my light. Did you feel us? Another star, you fade away. Afraid our aim is out of sight. Wanna see you.
So at this point I was really excited because this was the 250th Buckleby quest and I just finished it. And when I realized I ran over to, you know, claim the quest and all the rewards, and you can see I go over there. You can see I checked the shop. And you can see that I get the diamond star egg when I claim the quest. I go over, check the leaderboard, I get 250 in quests done. I go down, and I knew I wasn't going to be at the crafter already because I had already looked and I knew I needed some materials. So I was just expecting to craft every material afterward because I didn't think I would have enough beforehand. And then when I looked in my inventory, I realized I don't know if I have enough. So I went ahead and crafted, like I went over to craft it, and I didn't have enough. So as I said, I went over to the blender to craft the materials, and you can see as I go to the blender, this is when I realized I didn't actually have enough materials, like not even close to how much I needed to actually get the Tide Popper. I didn't have nearly enough blue extracts or purple potions, which were needed to make the swirled wax, and I needed even more blue extracts for those purple potions. Guess it's time for more grinding. Okay, so obviously I didn't do all the grinding using just sprouts because that would take plainly too long, and I did most of the grinding via macroing and just getting materials from macroing. So this whole thing took about 3 weeks or 4 weeks to actually get all the materials, which I probably could have done faster if I hadn't just macroed, but I was not gonna just sit there and waste my life just using sprouts. This is when I finally bought Tide Popper after, as I said, about a month, just because of those materials. I hated that so much. Alright, well, it's time to test the Tide Popper. So I'm gonna go to Pine. Obviously my hive is not the same as it was in the video, like before, when I actually was getting Tide Popper, because I got like Barabee, for example. I also don't have Windeevee, but the test should still work, and we're always going to test it in Pine Tree. Alright, so I'm going to put a 5-minute timer, as you can see in the bottom corner, and see how much I make.
Was it all in my fantasy? Where are you now?
I probably could have done better. I didn't do any boosts, of course, because I wanted to test it normally without any boosts. But I also, at the start, wasn't actually using my Tide Popper because apparently my clicks weren't registering. So, obviously, I didn't make as much as I probably could have. I only made about 2.25 billion. But that is still a lot more than I normally would have made with the Spirit Wand. This was an awesome journey and really crazy. And honestly, it's just still crazy to me that I was actually able to get Tide Popper after, again, 4 or 5 years of playing Beastworm. So please like and subscribe. And of course, thank you for watching.